announcing the arrival of the head of Center of Islamic Development and Management Studies, Dr. Shahir Akram Hassan. Professor from Islamic Development and Management Studies, Professor Dr. Muhammad Shukri Saleh.
Here, our first presenter today, we have Professor Muhammad Shukri bin Saleh. Beliau adalah Professor of Islamic Development Management from Center for Islamic Development Management, University Science Malaysia. And I think I need to introduce you to this University Science Malaysia as the top three best university in Malaysia, and also a research and APAC university, and it is also in the university world rankings. Yeah, Prof. Let me tell you a little bit more about Professor Shukri. So Professor Shukri's current position is as Professor of Islamic Development Management. He's also an adjunct professor at Faculty of Islamic Development Management, University Islam, Sultan Syarif Ali, Brunei Darussalam. Give applause to Professor Shukri. In the same time, he is also an adjunct professor at School of Arts and Humanities and Social Sciences, Asia E University in Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia. And his area of specializations include Islamic Development Management, Islamic Economics, Islamic Political Economy, Islamic Revivalism, Development Studies, and Rural Development. And it is very interesting, if we look at his educational record, Professor Shukri completed his graduate diploma in Economics in 1980, Prof, long time ago. Beliau menyelesaikan studi diploma in Economics dari University of East Anglia, United Kingdom, and he completed his master's in rural development in the same university, University of East Anglia, United Kingdom, dan beliau menyelesaikan S3 atau PhD in Islamic Development dari Universitas Oxford, United Kingdom. Give applause to Professor Shukri. So, I would like to invite Prof Shukri to present his presentation. And the title of his presentation will be Consequences of Digital Era. Okay, once more, give round and applause to Professor Shukri. Please, Prof.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العظيم طبيب pun so, my beloved the honorable the patrons of Teknat Education Foundation Ibnu Ibu Hajjah Harnaini SS MPhD, the my beloved the honorable director of Universitas Teknokrat Indonesia Dr. Haji Muhammad Nasrullah Yusuf SEMBA, the honorable the head of Center for Islamic Management Studies and Science Malaysia Dr. Shahir Akram Hassan, the honorable honorary professor Dr. Haji Didin Mahafidin, Director of Al-Ghifari University, the honorable all faculty members and students of Universitas Teknologi Indonesia, the honorable all teachers and students of Senior High School in Lampung Province. First of all, I would like to thank Pak Nasrullah for inviting us here in Lampung. Alhamdulillah, inshallah, today I would like to share my thinkings of the consequences of digital era, inshallah, and the aims of the speech is very simple. I would like to see the consequences of the digital era, and I'm going to stress on two consequences. The first one is the deglobalization, and the second one is what we call the post-normal times. Then inshallah, for the solutions, Dr. Sahil will try to express the solution inshallah, and then we start to think whatever that we can do within the situations of the digital era inshallah. Saya inshallah akan bercakap berkenaan dengan perkara yang sangat mudah untuk melihat kesan-kesan daripada era digital sekarang ini inshallah, dan kesan yang saya akan bincangkan hanyalah dua sahaja, yaitu apa yang dipanggil sebagai deglobalization atau apa yang dipanggil sebagai the end of globalization insyaallah, dan yang kedua ialah apa yang dipanggil sebagai post normal times. Ya, dan selepas itu nanti insyaallah solusinya akan disambung diberikan oleh Dr. Sahir Akram, termasuk jawapan kepada apa yang Pak Rektor tanya tadi ya, berkenaan dengan riba insyaAllah. For the beginnings, let's venture into the meanings of the digital era insyaAllah. So come on to the other slide. Right, this is the meaning of digital era. It is character. It is characterized by technology which increases the speed and breadth of knowledge turnover within the economy society. Maknanya digital era ini adalah merupakan satu era, satu zaman yang ada kemena-menganya dengan the speed of the knowledge. Jadi artinya ilmunya berkembang dengan laju sekali. But in fact, now we are talking about Industrial Revolution 4.0, which means that actually the three industrial revolution has passed. The difference between each digital revolution is the analogs and the digital. Artinya berbezanya antara Industrial Revolution yang pertama, kedua, ketiga dengan yang keempat ini ialah antara analog dengan digital. Jadi dalam Industrial Revolution yang keempat ini, ia berbentuk digital, bukan lagi berbentuk analog. Kalau mau ini di sana. Okay. One thing which is very important, the components of the digital era is what we call artificial intelligence, AI. Salah satu komponen yang sangat penting dalam revolusi industri ini ialah artificial intelligence yang membawa kepada fourth industrial revolution dan akhirnya memberi kesan kepada dua perkara yang saya cuba sebutkan, yaitu the end of globalization and also post-normal times. Kalau kita melihat kepada ini, So ini artificial intelligence ini, what we mean by artificial intelligence is data science learning machine. There are a lot of jargons in the digital artificial intelligence ini. Data science, learning machine, automated algorithms, analytical data, quantum, and etc. And then dia merubah satu suasana yang sangat penting. Misalnya dengan menggunakan algorithms, it is predicted that nanti our boss, our new boss, is no more human beings. So the boss will be algorithms. Jadi algorithms will be the new boss of us in the future. And apart from that, also drones will become the future machines. So the drone will be the future machines. And apart from that, the very exciting thing is that robotics will be human intuitions. And in fact now, sekarang ini, sudah ada manusia, sudah ada robot yang menyerupai manusia. Tapi dalam bentuk perempuan, yang namanya Sofia. Jadi Sofia sekarang ini sudah menjadi warga negara Saudi Arabia. Saudi Arabia telah menerima Sofia itu sebagai warga negaranya. Dan ramai orang lelaki membeli Sofia sebagai teman hidupnya. Kerana Sofia boleh melakukan apa saja sebagai seorang isteri. Dan yang bagusnya Sofia ini tak ada cemburunya. Jadi orang-orang lelaki cukup suka dengan itu kerana fungsi sebagai isteri, sebagai wanita dijalan dengan penuh tanpa perasaan cemburu. So we'll see in the next, and in fact even now there are people, there are men who likes to get Sofia instead of a woman. So be careful woman, ya, yeah? Because you will be excess and be redundant or irrelevant one day in the future if Sofia becomes the dominant robots that can fulfill the man's needs. Okay, itu the antara perkara-perkara. Alright, so sekarang let's discuss about the two consequences that we are saying just now. The end of globalization. Yeah, we were talking, a lot of people were talking about globalization, yeah? But then now people start not to talk about globalization anymore because globalization will end, globalization will end soon because of the artificial intelligence. Last time globalization happened because the capitalists were trying to search for a cheap labor. So they came to our countries, they came to other third world countries like Malaysia, Vietnam, Indonesia and all that to get the cheap labor, so that the cost of production is cheaper and then the profit is high. But then now within the digital era, the labor, by the adoptions of the robots and also artificial intelligence, so they don't need any more cheap labor from human beings because they can always use the machines to do their works and to produce the productions as much as they like. And then they found that actually the artificial intelligence is invented in their own country. So they started to close their industries in our country, going back to their own country, get the artificial intelligence as a means of production to produce with the cheap capital. So now we can see that there are a lot of industries that has been closed in the third world countries because they started to go back to their own country and use the artificial intelligence as a means of production with a very cheap and also with a not too costly as opposed to the cheap labor in the third world countries. Jadi sekarang ini adalah menjadi satu, boleh kita anggap satu pemikiran agak terkebelakang kalau sekiranya kita bercakap berkenaan globalisasi. Sebab sekarang ini para pemikir telah mula bercakap tentang berakhirnya globalisasi dengan penggunaan artificial intelligence itu, kerana artificial intelligence itu adalah murah berbanding dengan the cheap labor, berbanding dengan buruh yang murah, buruh manusia yang murah di negara-negara dunia ketiga. So be prepared. That's about, because the consequences, the one of the consequences that will be having the unemployment, because the industry tutup, and then dia balik kepada negara mereka sendiri, jadi pekerjaan semakin kurang, dan kita akan melihat nanti di negara-negara dunia ketiga, ya, banyak pengangguran berlaku. So in order to face that, definitely we have to think of how to overcome the problems of unemployment that will be happening soon if the digital era continues. Okay, that's one. Yeah. Number two is what we call the post-normal times. So within the digital era now, we are very uncertain. Yeah, the characteristics of the post-normal time sekarang ini, artinya pasca waktu pasca yang biasa, yang karakternya itu adalah uncertainty, tidak kepastian, rapid change, perubahan yang berlaku dengan cepat sekali, the realignment of power, kuasa berubah-ubah, termasuk di Malaysia, bagaimana kuasa berubah daripada dominan parti yang memerintah selama 62 tahun kepada satu parti yang baru. Kemudian ada chaotic behavior oleh kerana digital era itu, manusia telah menjadi chaotic, ya, telah menjadi kelam kabut. And in fact, there are a lot of research which prove that actually those youngsters who are indulged ataupun obsessed with the gadgets, they are more aggressive and more violent as opposed to the one who do not really use the gadgets. Right? The main forces, sebab yang sangat penting dalam melahirkan karakter-karakter dunia yang sebegitu rupa ialah complexity dan juga chaos dan contradiction. There are a lot of contradictions. Ada kontradiksi-kontradiksi antara satu kumpulan dengan satu kumpulan, antara individu dengan individu. So we'll foresee that there'll be probably three tomorrows, apa yang dipanggil sebagai tiga hari esok. The first one is what we call the extended present. That most probably in the future, within the digital era, we'll have the same things as now that we are having now, but that it is extended. That's not too dangerous because I'm very familiar with the things. But then the second tomorrow is the what we call a familiar futures. Kita akan berdepan dengan satu masa depan yang kita biasa hadapi. Itu juga tidak sangat bahaya, ya. But then the most dangerous that will be faced within the digital era is what we call the untold futures, iaitu masa depan yang kita tidak terfikir akan berlaku, tidak boleh diramalkan apa yang akan berlaku, tiba-tiba berlaku, and then we are not prepared to face that problems. So now we are within the uncertainty. Actually, this is what we call, we are now in between the period where all orthodoxies are dying, orthodoxy yang biasa sedang mati, but then new ones have yet to emerge, yang baru belum lagi timbul, and then apa jua boleh berlaku dan tidak bersalah lagi kepada logik dan sebagainya. Jadi sekarang ini we are hanging, kita sedang bergantung antara no longer, but we're not going to have the same things that we're having now, dengan not yet, apa yang akan berlaku itu, and then therefore we are quite unstable within the digital era at the moment. Jadi kita tidak begitu stable kerana kita akan berdepan dengan kemungkinan berdepan dengan tiga hari esok. Yang pertama, apa yang dipanggil sebagai masa kini yang dipancangkan, itu tidak berapa bahaya. Atau yang keduanya ialah masa depan yang biasa kita tempuh sekarang ini, tetapi yang bahayanya ialah masa depan yang kita tidak terfikir apa yang akan berlaku, dan dia boleh berlaku secara mengejut. Nah, itu antara perkaranya. Jadi deglobalization and post-normal times are two main consequences of the digital era that we have to face, insyaAllah. And then so I think that's all that I want to say. Thank you very much. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.